So hello everyone, welcome to Trend Education. In this video, I'm going to explain you what is cluster analysis in data mining. So what is cluster analysis? So before seeing what is cluster analysis, we have to know what is cluster first. So once we know what is cluster, then we'll easily predict that what is cluster analysis. So first we'll see what is cluster. So cluster is nothing but a group, so which is called as a group. So there are many terms which means the cluster, but I'm telling it as group. So what is group? You easily know that a group is something which is a similar type of object. Okay, how should be the group here is a meaningful. That means the data should have the natural structure. So this is why the meaningful. It should not be a false or fake. It should be as it is. The data should be as the data in the data format. So how it is useful in the sense, it's very easily when comparing a group and an object. When using grouping, we can easily predict this is a good group, this is a bad group. But in data, it's very difficult to find out, and it's very difficult to determine the data, the type of the data. And yeah, let's see what is, how we are going to group that cluster, that is how we are going to group the data, and based on some information found in the data. So the information will given, so we are going to use that information, that is we are going to use that data, and we are going to describe the objects, and then we are going to group every objects into a separate or a group. So I'll explain you now a simple example which is students. So how we will classify, that is how we'll group students as average student, toppers and poor student. So you can easily predict that average student means the one who is getting about 60 to 80 marks, and the toppers are nothing but the students who are scoring more than 80%, and the poor means the student who have failed and who are less than 60% will consider as poor. So this is how we group the students. Hope you understand what is clustering. So we are going to group the students as average student, topper student and poor student. So now coming to the topic, cluster analysis. What we are going to do is we are going to find out the group of objects. We are going to group every object. So we have to find out the correct group of that object. So here you can say the object as student. So it's not object, it's a student. So we are going to find out the group of student, correct group of the student. How we are going to find out? By using the information or the data. So using the information or the data, we are going to find out the group of the object, group of the student. And the group of the student, and the average student should be different from the toppers and the poor. And the poor student are different from the average and the topper. So the objects in one group should be different from others. The object in one group should be different from others. So this is the cluster analysis. Now I'll explain with another example. So this is here you can see that there are four types of objects. So how you are saying that there are four type of objects, it's a round shape and star shape, square shape and diamond shape. So I am clustering everything as a single group. You can see that find out the group of objects I founded the group from the information given, and the object in one group is different from the other group. You can easily see that round is different from the star shape. Star shape is different from the square shape. So this is what the cluster analysis means. Now I'll explain you the goal. And so coming to the goal, so it's very easy because there is only two goals. One is find the similar objects. So we have to find the similar objects, which means we are going to find out the round shapes alone. So find similar objects or the related objects. And the second one is how one object is different. That is one object, object in a group is different from other object in another group. So you can see easily how this round is different from this star. So this is what the goal, find similar objects. And then how one object, that is one object in this group, in a group, is different from the other, that is this, from the objects in another group. How the objects in this group and the objects in these groups are different. So this is what the goal, find the similar objects, that is this, and find how one object in a group is different from this another object. If you like this video, then give me a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel and share with your friends. If you want me to explain any type of video, feel free to ask me in the comment section. And also if you want me to explain any type of video in computer science, you can directly ask me in the comment section. And yeah, thank you. Bye.